Well, first of all, I mean, I have many graphs of information technology in all these different areas, and it's not just computers. It's our health technologies, it's our knowledge about the brain. It's, in fact, these technologies apply to things like solar energy and water and many different areas, and they follow these very smooth, very predictable exponential curves. And exponential growth ultimately is explosive. In 25 years, computation and these other information technologies will be a billion times more powerful than it is today. And I say this now not just looking backwards and overfitting to past data. I've been making forward-looking predictions like this for many years, for decades. In the 1980s, I said there would be a world wide web of communication tying together hundreds of millions of people emerging in the mid-1990s. That seemed ridiculous and was heavily criticized when the entire defense budget could only tie together a few thousand scientists. But it was growing exponentially, and I recognized the explosive potential of exponential growth. And in fact, it happened right on schedule. And there's been many other predictions like this. Now you might say, well, isn't there a limit to the ability of matter and energy to support information technology like computation? And the answer is yes, there's a limit, but it's not very limiting. I talk about this in chapter 3 of my book, the ultimate 1 kilogram computer, 2 pounds of matter and energy organized to be optimal for computation would be literally trillions of times more powerful than the human brain. And so yes, it's a limit, but it's not very limiting. It ultimately will be profoundly transformative as we get to those limits. And then you might say, well, isn't there a limit to the current paradigms we use, like Moore's law, where we're shrinking the size of components on an integrated circuit? And yes, Moore's law was in fact not the first paradigm to bring exponential growth to computing. It's the fifth paradigm. We had four paradigms before it. Each one of those ran out of steam. But what happens when one paradigm runs out of steam, it creates research pressure to create the next paradigm. And the next paradigm is there in time. In the 1950s, we built computers not with chips, but with vacuum tubes. And they were shrinking the vacuum tubes, making them smaller and smaller each year to keep this exponential growth going. That hit a wall. It got to a point where they couldn't shrink the vacuum tube anymore and keep the vacuum. And that was the end of the shrinking of vacuum tubes. But it was not the end of the exponential growth of computing. We then went to the fourth paradigm, transistors, and then chips. And there's been regular predictions, oh, Moore's law will come to an end. Gordon Moore first said 2002. Intel now says 2022. And by that time, the key features will be 4 nanometers, and we won't be able to shrink them anymore. And that's true. But we will then go to the sixth paradigm, which will replace Moore's law and chips, which are flat. They're very dense already, but they're two-dimensional. We live in a three-dimensional world. I've been predicting that around the teen years of this century, we will switch to three-dimensional circuits using self-organizing molecular circuits. And that was a controversial notion when I wrote about that in my book, Age of Spiritual Machines, around 1999. There's been so much progress in the last decade that that's now very much a mainstream view. And if you speak to the Intel scientists, as I did recently, in fact, Justin Ratner, the chief technology officer of Intel, just spoke at the Singularity Summit and talked about this research, and they have these three-dimensional circuits working in their labs. The crossover point will be no later than the teen years, well before we run out of steam with conventional two-dimensional circuits. So every time one paradigm runs out of steam, the next paradigm is there to keep it going. We have plenty of room to get through the end of the century through continued exponential growth of information technology. By that time, it will have already profoundly transformed our civilization by creating computers that are trillions of times more powerful than the human brain.